On the Democratic side, we ask this question often of our Democratic guests in studio. Who do you think, who is the leader of the Democratic Party today? And where is the Democratic Party going?
Well, I last time I was on, I sort of waxed poetic all over the place on this. I mean, the Democratic Party, I am of the mindset that, you know, we have lost our way as far as being able to talk to, you know, our blue-collar Reagan D's, the people, again, that I represented for a decade. If we don't come up with a way to communicate with those folks and lead with our economic message, now that doesn't mean that we abandon our progressive principles having to do with, you know, equality and LGBT and pro-choice and all the things that, you know, immigration, et cetera. But it means we lead with an economic message. Whom is the leader of the Democratic Party is a much larger and much more complex question. I think we need to look to the states. However, because we have no farm team, that's a challenge. I always point to my member of Congress, Tim Ryan, who has been probably one of the more vocal people against
Nancy Pelosi. He's great. We love him. We love him. Favorite guest of our show.
I was his constituent and he was mine. We're both Trumbull County kids and, you know, very much cut from the same cloth, trying to bring some order and some heart back to the Democratic Party that, you know, we grew up with.
Right. And have you ever seen, like you, I'm not sure there is any one leader of the Democratic Party today, which frankly doesn't bother me because I think there's so much grassroots activity, so much energy on the part of
how do we harness it?
Emily's List and MoveOn.org and Our Revolution. I mean, they're all just, they're doing great things. These town halls, the protests at the U.S. Capitol last week. Indivisible. Yeah, with the town. So how do we harness it there? I don't know. They're doing a pretty good job on their own
now. But we need to coalesce them, and that's the challenge.
Right.
And we need to show up for midterm elections. That is no joke. We lose because we don't show up for midterm elections. When we don't show up for midterms, that means we lose state houses, gubernatorials, et cetera, et cetera. And that means a difference. I mean, had we shown up in 2014, guess what? Merrick Garland would have been the Supreme Court justice. But because we lost the Senate, because we didn't show up in 2014, this is where we're at.
Right.
So elections have consequences, and we need to figure out how to harness this into showing up for midterms, a 50-state strategy for redistricting and reapportionment reform, because that's competitive districts is the only way we're going to be able to play again. I mean, we got a lot of work to do.